Welcome back, everybody. We are getting ready to start our last section in Chapter 1. So, go ahead and we're just going to go through these first little bit and then go through the rest of the examples in class. So, when talking about inequalities, a lot of times we solve these very similar to equations, but instead of us getting one or two answers, we're going to get a whole solution set of answers. So for example, in 1a, we're going to get our x's to one side, so we add 2x to both sides to get 5x, and then add 5 to both sides, so we have 5x is less than 11. Then we divide by 5, so we get that x is less than 11 over 5. Now, to graph the solution set, we're going to make a number line. We have 0 here, and then 11 over 5 is above 0. And then because it is strictly less than, we're going to have an open circle above 11 over 5, and then it's going to be shaded to the left because it's less than. And so for B, we're going to solve it the same way. So I'm going to subtract 10x from both sides, so I have negative 17x is greater than or equal to, and then subtract 13 from both sides, so negative 4 minus 13 is negative 17. Now, when we divide by a negative with inequalities, something special happens. So when we divide by negative 17, then we have to switch the way that our inequality is facing. Negative 17 divided by negative 17 is positive 1. So then we have x is less than or equal to 1. So we draw our number line again, 0, 1. And now because it's less than or equal to, we're going to have a closed circle, and then we shade to the left. Now, if we were writing the domain of these, so this is just graphing. If we were writing the domain, the way that we would write A is this would be parentheses negative infinity all the way up to 11 over 5. And then if it's an open circle, it's going to have a parentheses. Whereas in B, if it was a closed circle, this would be a bracket. And so this will come more in place whenever we're talking about our domain. So then, if we look at example 2a, we know that we can't have a zero, or we can't have anything negative under r square root, which means that x minus 6 has to be greater than or equal to 0. So x has to be greater than or equal to 6. So if we draw our number line, this would be 6 with a closed dot and going to the right. And so as we write our domain, it's going to have a bracket 6 to infinity. So we can use our graphs to help us to see whether or not it's going to be a bracket or a parentheses. Now, for B, because we have a square root and it's in the denominator, we kind of have two different restrictions on our domain. First off, we know that the square root of 3 minus x cannot be 0. And we also know that 3 minus x has to be greater than or equal to 0. Now, because we have both of these, we could solve them each individually, but basically, we can also just do that 3 minus x has to be strictly greater than 0, because if it's greater than or equal to 0 but not 0, it's just strictly greater than. So then we finish solving this, so negative x is greater than negative 3, and then when we divide by that negative, it switches our sign. So we have x has to be less than 3. And so, again, if it helps you to draw this out, that's going to be an open circle into the left, which means that it'll be negative infinity to 3 And so we're just going to talk about what a conjunction and disjunction is, and then we'll go over these examples in class. But conjunction means that it's going to be and disjunction means that it's or. And we'll talk more about what those mean in